Yes, a new short form factor of video on learning Lightburn. No bull. Let's get straight to it. Short and concise in under 5 minutes. Let's go. Good morning and welcome back. I'm Andy and thank you for joining me today. So we are going to create a star and then we're going to add that to an art library. So if you're interested, continue watching. So there may be many ways to draw a star, but this is the way I prefer to do it. So go and select the polygon tool, press your shift key, left click the mouse and drag a polygon out any size, release the mouse key and then release the shift key. Now go into shape properties. If you don't see shape properties, go up to window and down here you'll find shape properties. Give it a click and that window will appear. So with the shape selected, we are going to make it five-sided. And I don't like to work upside down, so I then use this button at the top, mirror selection, and it will flip it upright. Now we're going to select the pencil tool, and we're going to draw some lines. So let me just zoom it in a little bit. Okay, so we're going to go from there, to there, to there, there. I'm just left clicking. And then right click to finish. Okay, so we have a star, but now we need to delete some stuff. So selection tool, select on the outside shape and delete. Now there's two ways of doing this. If you've got the snipping tool, you can go around and snip those, but I prefer to use the offset tool. So select the shape, select the offset tool, select the distance to zero, outwards or inwards, it doesn't matter, but not both. I want the corners to be beveled and delete original body and set OK. And there you have the perfect star. Now at the moment, that is a line because my red layers are normally lines. If we go over to laser and cut layers, you can see it's line. So if I change that to a blue layer, select that to blue, that automatically goes to fill. Okay, so we have our perfect star, and now we are going to create art libraries. Again, if you don't have the art library attached to your menu, go up to Windows and select art library and it will pop up. If it pops up out here somewhere, don't worry, you can click on it, drag it, and when it turns blue, so I've used the left mouse button, just release the left mouse button and it will appear down here. Now I have a library already called Basic Shape, so I'm going to make a new library for this demonstration. So I forgot to delete that, so I'm sorry about that. So I'm going to click new, and this is where I've stored on my PC my art library. So I do have many art libraries, but for this demonstration I turned them all off. So I'm going to make one Shapes Basic 2 just for this demonstration and save that. And you can see now we've got another menu has appeared called Shapes Basic 2. Now there's nothing in there at the moment, so if we go back with the selection tool and click on the star, you can see now this box is highlighted. It says import graphic from project, so you say yes and you're gonna say 5-pointed star, whatever you want to call it, and there you can see, so it's appeared in your art library. So you've got your first art library. You can change the size of the icons by using the slider box here, so depending, you know, how many you've got, you can set it to whatever you prefer. So now we're going to delete the star. So just going to go back, highlight it, press delete, and it's gone. You think, oh my gosh, I want to use my star I've just drawn. So remember, it's in your art library. So all you do is when you're in your project, you find your shape in your art library. And it's important to name them because you can see you've got a search box here. It doesn't seem necessary at the moment because you've got one shape, but in a few months' time, you might have 50 shapes. So you can use the search box to say, so what I've done here just as demonstration to show you the search, well, the powerful search feature of your art library, I've loaded in some extra Art library. So remember, we made, what do we call it, five pointed star. So if you know the library that you put it in, you can obviously click on that and you would find it. But let's say you've got, you know, you might have 50, 100, 20, and you don't know which library you've stored it in, but you know you want a star. So I'm going to go in the search box and type star. And it brought up this art library. Click on it and you found your star. So let's try another one. I think I've got one, money, I think it's called. Bitmap miscellaneous, I think that is in. Click on there and it's found anything in that library associated to money. So I've called these, I don't know where I've got these from, but if you drag that in, it's a dollar bill. Not a very good graphic because it's got a white background, but we can cover that in another video. But that's the power of naming your art correctly and thinking, when you name it, what would you type in to search for it? So if you just type in money, you'll find these, but I could have called that 25 money dollar bill. So it would search for, you know, if you typed in dollar bill money, it would find that one if I had called it money dollar bill. Anyway, I hope you get that. It was just a bit more interesting than just showing you the five star. So just to highlight one feature that I didn't actually mention, but I think you all know it by now. If you drag that in and you've got the handles and you press control and drag it in, you can resize the star to any shape. Because it is a vector, it will go to whatever size you're doing. So if you're doing some fine detail, you can make it as small as you really want. I mean, that is those squares, those big squares are 10 mil. So if you want a 10 mil one, you can drag it out here, or you can size it up here. Now, if you're going to resize it up here, make sure the padlock is locked, so then it will scale in its dimensions properly, or you can use the percentage buttons to scale it to whatever size you want. So to use the shape in your art library, all you do is click on the shape, drag it in, and it puts it on the layer that it was already on. And for me, I've set my speed to 9,000 at 40. So there you go. That is how to draw a star and how to store your work in an art library. It's very simple. Any questions, pop them down below and I will answer them. If you like the video, please support my channel. Please like, subscribe and comment, and I will come back to you as quick as I can. But remember, like you, I go to sleep. So that's Andy now wishing you a great afternoon. Continue to make some happy smoke, and I'll hopefully see you in the next one. Cheers for now. So that's it, another quick tip video on how to use Lightburn. If you found this video of value, please like the video, and better still, if you subscribe to the channel, I'll be forever grateful. Perhaps you would like to watch some of the videos popping up now. Let me know what you think.